Hi, this is video three for Ruby's Garden Block of the Month from Fawns and Porter. I am Jenny K. Parks, taking you every step of the way. If you want to know more about me, you can check out my website, jennykquilts.com. Now, the kit for this, all the fabrics are by Paintbrush Studios, these beautiful 1930s fabrics, gorgeous. And you can get the kit and it'll have everything to go in it. Now, today we're going to cover string pieced border. This is a really cool technique. Very scrappy, very free-flowing, and I think you're going to have a lot of fun with it. So let me show it to you here. Here we go. Ready? Look at that. Isn't that? It's bright and scrappy and fun. You're going to love it. You're going to have a lot of fun with this one. So let's get started. String piecing, I have to confess, string piecing is not something that I did a lot of. What you're going to need to do is make a big foundation for your string piecing. I'm going to show you a small one because maneuvering a big one on here can be challenging. Now you can make a paper foundation that is the appropriate width and the necessary length that you want to. I would suggest also making it just a little bit longer than it needs to be in case you need to slide it over or trim a little bit more off, because you'll notice on the quilt behind me that we trim them off at an angle, and you just want to be ready for that. Make sure you got plenty off to the side, maybe just another inch or two. What I found, so you can use regular paper to make a foundation for yourself. You can also use freezer paper because that'll give you plenty of length. What I did is I went to the store, the fabric store, and I got this grid, and it's lightweight and cheap, and it's a nice foundation, and these are inch measurements, so that helped me. And I made foundations that were like an inch and a half wider than I needed and a couple inches longer, so that when I sewed it, in case anything scrunched down, I had plenty of real estate to work with and I could just trim it down as needed. So here we are. This is the foundation that I'm going to show you how to use. This is the one I opted for. Now you're going to take your pieces that you cut that came in your kit, and I'm going to show you. Let's start with a yellow in the middle. Now we really want stuff to be just nice and scrappy. And the fun angles, right? Lots of different angles, that's great. You're gonna have cut these in, you can see I've got some different sizes, and you use that to give you plenty of variety and movement in there. What I tried to avoid was sticking the same colors right next to each other, but you know, if it randomly happens, it's okay. You can, if you want to, you can do these straight up and down and in perfect lines and everything, but I think the strip piecing, the wonkiness of it, I think that makes it so much more exciting. So I'm gonna take this center one. We're gonna pretend that this is the center of my nice wide border. I'm gonna take this center one and lay it a little bit over the edge here and kind of put it at a wonky angle. Then I'm gonna take, let's take this guy. I'm gonna take this fabric and I'm gonna sew them right next to each other. So I'm gonna get a nice line here. Now, just for ease of sewing and moving it back and forth from the machine and whatnot, I'm going to cut off that portion down there once I have it laid on. And that goes scraps, ready to be used for the next time we do it, ready to use it for something again. All right, now you see my foundation's at an angle, and I'm going to cut this at an angle. I'm going to sew it at an angle. All right. And you want to leave, of course, the quarter inch seam allowance there. Now, this is going to give you, I'm telling you, so much variety and fun, and you can play with it and see, do I like this? Do I like that? Do I like these colors together? Maybe I do, maybe I don't. And then you can try it on different border, because the borders that we're going to work with lots of different things. So let me press this, and I'm going to put a few on for you. Now, one thing about this stuff is that you don't want to get it too hot. You don't want to mess it up with your iron. So I made a very, very fancy pressing cloth. This is just a piece of muslin that I ripped out, and it's small enough, and I can kind of see through it, so I can make sure I'm not making any mistakes. And it really helps me with the pressing in this project. All right, so I'm just going to line it up under here. Oops, let me move this whole thing up here a little farther. And I'm going to press that up. And if your iron is going to, and I turned my iron way down too, you definitely test this first because you don't want to make a mistake and, you know, burn the paper or shrivel it up or something like that. And if any part of the iron is going to touch it, then I'd also cover up that part as well. Okay, here we have the first part. All right, so I want to do something a little bit different. I'm going to take this blue here, and I am going to go this way. All right, so I'm going to lay it on that way. This is going to be fun. And you see, you don't worry about cutting off the salvages or anything like that. When we trim it down to the right size, that's when you're going to cut everything off and make sure everything's even. I just make sure I have plenty over so I don't cut myself short. So I'm going to lay that on there. And now when I sew, I'm going to do a quarter inch along this fabric here that I just put on the top. All right. Lower the foot. So I'm following along the blue fabric that I just put down. It's kind of fun to have this improvisational, free-flowing type of thing because most of quilting is so precise. It's kind of fun to just say, I'm going to do it this way this time, and I'm going to try it this way another time. In fact, the more you do that in these borders, the better your results are going to be, the more scrappy, the more fun that it's going to look. All right, so here we have this piece here. Now, I need to trim this off, right? I don't want that extra bulk on there. So I have a good trick. You can get these add a quarter rulers, which are genius for this, and I'm going to flip it over. My add a quarter ruler on. And what it does is it adds a quarter of an inch. It has a little lip here. And this little lip measures a quarter of an inch from that seam. So it kind of tucks in right there. And it's great to cut with. This is wonderful. It also works well for paper piecing. So I cut right along that line. I don't need that anymore. Look at this. Pull it back out. And so you would just continue to press. So what I did when I'm doing this, when I was making the borders, is I would stitch one on this side and one on the other side at the same time. I would, you know, lay them both out, stitch them both, and trim them both. I think the more that you can do together at the same time, the better you're going to get at it, the faster you're going to get, the better results you're going to get. And that's what we all want, right? Some good results. Okay, so that's your inner piece, your inner string border. Have fun with it. Just, you know, enjoy it. Enjoy this whole process. The next episode, we are going to cover your inner applique border. And that's going to be really interesting. You're not going to want to miss it because I'm going to show some beautiful folded flowers and all kinds of stuff. You're going to love it, and I'll see you there.
This lesson of Ruby's Garden Block of the Month is brought to you by Paintbrush Studios, fabrics for your masterpiece.